Hey guys, if you haven't already, really appreciate it if you hit subscribe. Also hit the bell icon if you want to be notified anytime we upload anything that's saddle hunting related. And hopefully you like the video. If you do, give us a like. We really appreciate your support. I had a special request in one of our the comments on our channel. Somebody had asked a question on one of our videos. We had done a video almost a year ago now talking about using a Ropeman versus using a Prusik on your tether. And using, you know, most of the saddle hunting kits that are out there come with a Prusik to clip onto your carabiner to go onto your bridge for your saddle. But a lot of guys see the benefit to using a Ropeman on the tether because the Ropeman is so much easier to adjust. And a Ropeman is fine on a tether. It's an approved descender, and it'll work, and there's no problem with it. The only thing is there was a couple guys who did a little bit of independent testing, and they found that if you put, I forget what the exact number was, it was over 1,000 pounds of pressure, but somewhere between 1,000 to 2,000 pounds of pressure, I think, just going off recollection. If you put that much pressure on it, the teeth on your Ropeman can damage the outer shell of your tether, so it can compromise your tether, and your life is on that line. And you know, you say, well, geez, you know, 1,000 or 2,000 pounds, I mean, how's it going to see that? But you know, there was a couple guys who were engineers, and they pointed out that about 160-pound man falling, you know, a foot or 2 feet, depending on how far they fall into it, they could potentially shock load it. And that shock load on the rope and on the tether can actually greatly increase that pressure. So it can actually get over, you know, I guess you'd have to do the math and the physics of it. I don't remember exactly what it was, but very high number. And, you know, there is the potential that you could shock load it enough where you can actually damage the tether with the teeth of the Ropeman. So that was the concern. You know, that's kind of unlikely. Usually in a saddle hunting situation, you always have pressure on it. But you know, I can kind of see where if somebody has a platform and they're adjusting their tether maybe, and they're standing up on the platform and they've got all their weight on their platform, and maybe they create some slack in the tether, a big guy, and the tether, let's say the platform were to fail and they fell into it and shock load the system, the potential to create a lot of pressure on the teeth and into on the teeth of your Ropeman and into your tether, that potential is there. So somebody had asked, you know, we had made this video about a year ago discussing that, and we thought that, you know, maybe it's just safer to stay on your Prusik versus the Ropeman. But you know, the Ropeman sure is nice to adjust. It's just so nice and easy. So somebody had asked a question on our channel. You know, can you use both? And I did see this one other time. It's not like I came up with the idea. I did see somebody else showed this once, and I thought it was a great idea for somebody who wants to use both. Basically, what you can do is you can take your Ropeman, if you like to use your Ropeman, and you can take a Prusik, a double eye factory Prusik, and install it. You put one eye on either side of your Ropeman, and then just tie your Prusik. Here what I did was I tied a French Prusik, which is basically just 7 wraps from the bottom to the top, and then goes back down and connects up to your carabiner on either side of the Ropeman. It's very easy to tie a French Prusik, and they also break easy if you want to adjust them, and it works just fine. So if I want to adjust this, I just move it up and it moves up, no problem. If I want to adjust it down, the only thing you want to do is put your hand above the Prusik, and then when you pull the cam on your Ropeman, you slide them both down. So the only thing that would be, you know, I could see it being a little bit of a pain doing this if you're hooked up and you're pulling on one hand. You need both hands to adjust it in the one direction. But to adjust it up and tighter, you just need the one hand. It's not going to be a problem. So I think it would work just fine. And the nice thing about it is it creates some redundancy in your system. If, you know, God forbid something were to happen where you shock loaded that rope, the ropeman, and it affected anything there, that Prusik is above it high enough where it should grab and, you know, it should catch you. And, you know, it might be overkill in the system, but you know what? There's a lot of guys who probably like the idea of having, you know, a backup. And, you know, single points of failure. I like eliminating single points of failure and creating some redundancy in your system. And it's really nothing to do if you bought a saddle kit, it probably came with a Prusik anyway. You know, hopefully it's a nice factory double eye Prusik like this, and they're a little easier to tie that it up like this. You can do, you know, like I said, I did this with a French Prusik. You can also tie what's called a distal hitch. That would also work well, and just catch it on either side. And it works really well. Adjusts really easy, no problem. You know, best of both worlds. You know, why not? All right, guys, hopefully you liked that video. Climb safe and best of luck.